Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will learn a technique for converting fractions to decimals. Let's get started. So here I have my fraction 3/5 or 3/5 that I need to convert to a decimal. Now to do that, I need to remember that a fraction just means division, where I take my denominator and I divide it in to my numerator. And now I can see that 5 goes into 3. Well, that's a little tricky because 3 is smaller than 5. So I need to rely on my knowledge of dividing with decimals. So I add my decimal point after my 3 here, and I can add some trailing zeros afterwards. And remember, I need to bring my decimal point right up above to the same point. And now I can divide. 5 goes into 30 how many times? From your 5 fact families, you might know that that is 6, and 5 times 6 is 30. So when I subtract here, I get a 0. So now I'm done with this division problem. So this tells me that 3/5 was equal to 3 goes into 5, a division problem, which is equal to 0.6. And that is the decimal that is equivalent, this one here. So now I have another example where I need to convert 2/10 to a decimal. So remember, the first thing I do here is convert this into a division problem. So I'm going to say 10 goes into 2 how many times? And when I write that out, I see again I have that problem because my dividend is smaller than my divisor. So I have to add my decimal point and some trailing zeros. And I bring my decimal point right up above. And now I can say 10 goes into 20 how many times? Well, that's 2 times, right? And 2 times 10 is 20. So when I subtract these, I get a 0. And now I'm complete. So I've converted my fraction 2/10 into a decimal, which is 0.2. That one there. Good, let's try one more that's a little more involved. So now I'm converting my fraction 7/8 to a decimal. So the first thing I do is I convert my fraction here into a division problem. 8 goes into 7 how many times? And it looks like I'm going to, again, need to add my decimal point, add those trailing zeros in. And now I can say 8 goes into 70 how many times? Well, 8 times 8 is 64. That might be the closest we get. Let's bring our decimal point up. So if we say 8 here, 8 times 8 we said was 64. And so now when I subtract here, I'm going to get a 6. And if I bring another 0 down, so now I'm saying how many times does 8 go into 60? Well, 8 times 7 gives me 56. And if I subtract these here, I'm going to get 4, and let's bring down another 0. See, we're already at 2 decimal points here. So now 8 goes into 40 how many times? 5 times. And this one does give me 8 times 5 is 40. So when I subtract those, I get a 0. So I've completed my division problem, and I see that my answer is 0.875, which is the equivalent decimal of 7/8 fraction. And there it is there. So great job learning how to convert fractions to decimals. Remember, the first thing we do is we convert our fraction into a division problem, and then we solve by dividing with decimals. Great work. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.